Assalamualaikum. My name is Armaghan Anjum. I am a research officer from Department of Orthotics and Prosthetic, GC University, Faisalabad. Today I am going to discuss about above knee prosthesis and its component. It is the first part of the presentation. Overview. First, I will discuss briefly about the introduction of the topic. Then I will discuss foot ankle assembly, then shank piece, then knee assembly, which is further divided into knee axis, knee control and extension. Introduction. What is above knee prosthesis and its component? Above knee prosthesis is an artificial device which is used by patients having transfemoral or above knee amputation. Its components are shown in figure. Its components include foot ankle assembly, shank, knee assembly, thigh piece and socket and suspension devices. In this presentation, we will discuss foot ankle assembly, shank and knee assembly, while thigh piece and socket and suspension devices will be presented in next presentation. Foot ankle assembly. Same foot ankle assembly can be used in above knee prosthesis as we discussed previously in below knee prosthesis. Foot ankle assembly includes single axis foot ankle assembly in which uniaxial motion is allowed, that is dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. Second type is SACH foot ankle assembly, that is solid ankle, cushion heel, foot ankle assembly in which motion is allowed by the cushioning of heel. While in multi-axial foot ankle assembly, dorsiflexion, plantar flexion as well as inversion and eversion is allowed. Shank. It is a structural member that connects foot ankle assembly with the knee unit. It is made up of wood covered with plastic laminate, which are used in conventional prosthesis, or it can be a tubular supporting member enclosed with soft cosmetic covering that are used in modular prosthesis. It differs from below knee prosthesis as it does not have a socket or it does not connect directly with the socket. Knee assembly. As shown in figure 2, it consists of wooden or plastic block, knee axis or bolt within block, knee fixation device and extension strap. Knee assembly should provide stability during early and mid stance, but must bend during later stance, swing phase, as well as in sitting and kneeling. Because during normal walking, bending of knee is required, especially in swing phase. Moreover, the assembly should be durable, comfortable and acceptable in appearance, which means amputee must feel safe, stable and not different from other individuals. Stability of knee joint can be achieved by one or more of the following methods. Amputation stump held knee stable during heel strike and standing by exerting backward force within the socket. Secondly, prosthesis may be aligned in such a way that knee axis is placed behind the weight line, so that when weight falls behind the knee axis, it will push the weight in front of knee axis, so extension may take place and knee become stable. Thirdly, a braking or locking mechanism can be used to prevent or resist excessive knee flexion. For normal gait, prosthetic knee joint should flex and extend freely during swing phase, which can be accomplished either by movement of stump muscles or by incorporating specific component in prosthetic knee joint in swing phase control. In order to bear amputee's weight rapidly without breaking down, knee unit should be relatively simple mechanism, which means the knee unit which we will use should have limited number of components. Moreover, it should be lightweight so that patient can lift it without any undue expense of energy. Knee axis. There are two kinds of knee axis used. First is single axis, as shown in the figure. It allows movement around single axis. It is most commonly used these days. Friction devices with or without extension end is used to control motion of shank. The tendency of knee to collapse during weight bearing is controlled by muscle power and alignment, which means if stump have great muscle power and we have done accurate alignment, the knee will not collapse during weight bearing. Its advantages are as it is simple, have low noise and maintenance and cheaper than other available options. Other option for knee joint access is polycentric access, as shown in figure 4. It is less frequently used because it has greater number of mechanical elements. Knee block and shank are attached by 4 bar linkage, and each linkage has its own axis of rotation. So rotation takes place around more than one axis, thus give the name polycentric axis. Poly means many, centric means center. It has many centers. The main advantage of this knee axis is inherent stability. So it is very useful for very short above knee amputation and bilateral amputation. The disadvantage of this knee axis is it is heavier and bulkier, require more maintenance and does not provide good swing phase control. But now newer designs are more compact and have friction devices to have good swing phase control, as shown in figure 5. Knee control. Knee control is used to provide stability during stance phase and control motion of the shank during swing phase. Mechanical as well as hydraulic, which are water-based, and pneumatic, which are air-based systems, are used to control knee. If such resistance is not provided, especially during fast walking, there will be excessive knee flexion during swing phase and abrupt stop with great impact at full extension during stance phase. Most commonly used knee controls are constant friction knee control, variable friction knee control, weight activated friction brake, and manual lock. Constant friction knee control. It is shown in figure 6. It is most commonly used friction device which provide constant friction throughout the swing phase. Friction is provided either by sleeve or spread brush with clamp around the knee axis. Friction can be increased or decreased by rotating friction adjustment screw, which in turn tightens and loosen sleeve or brush that is wounded around knee axis. But once the adjustment is made, it remains constant throughout the swing phase. That's why it is also referred as conventional single axis knee. Advantages of constant friction knee control are it is simple because there are less number of mechanical elements, low cost, low noise and maintenance, light in weight and easy to adjust. While this disadvantage includes, it cannot compensate for change in walking speed, so the amputee has to walk with a constant speed. Excessive heel raise, delayed swing through, and high impact on knee extension. Variable friction knee control. It provides variable degree of friction or braking action during swing phase, providing greater resistance during early and late swing phase, while less during mid swing phase. In one of such devices, as shown in figure 7, variation of braking action is provided by action of number of segmented friction elements that rotate together with knee axis. As knee moves, each part comes into play successively, increasing friction at the beginning and the end of swing phase. While friction adjustment screw can be rotated clockwise or anti-clockwise to increase or decrease friction. Advantages of variable friction knee control are it requires less energy than constant friction knee control because of less resistance in mid-swing. Moreover, it can be adjusted to slight to moderate change in walking speed, which gives some freedom to amputee in walking speed. These advantages include increased noise, greater maintenance because larger number of moving parts are involved. Weight activated friction brake. As name indicates, it will work when weight is borne. So it can be used to prevent sudden buckling of knee joint during stance phase. In swing phase, it behaves just like constant friction knee control. However, when weight is borne on prosthesis for first 15 to 20 degree of flexion, the braking system becomes activated, resisting further knee flexion. One of the variants, as shown in figure 8, the melting braking surfaces both in knee block and shank are in light contact during early swing phase. But as the weight is borne, the two braking surfaces are forced into each other, creating resistance to further knee flexion. Other variants are also available, which differ in construction but have same principle. The advantages of weight-activated friction brake are they are more stable, require less empathy, strength, and coordination, which means if the stem muscles are weak and empathy have poor coordination, they can be benefited by this system. While the disadvantages include more moving parts requiring more maintenance, heavier, noisier, require frequent adjustments. The last of knee control include manual lock, which is shown in figure 9. Maximum stability in stance phase can be achieved by manual locking. Therefore, this is indicated to those amputees requiring maximum stability during stance phase because of poor coordination and muscle weakness. The locking mechanism is manual, so it can be controlled by the amputee. Occasionally, it may be used in more active amputees whose occupation require maximum stability. The one and the most important advantage of this system is maximum stability. While disadvantages include no knee flexion because of manual lock and less cosmetic gait, due to which patient has to walk with compensatory motions. Extension aids. Some patients require additional mechanical assistance to control heel rise or accelerate shank during forward swing. For these motions, commonly used extension aids are kick strap and extension lever. Kick strap construction. As shown in figure 10, it consists of elastic portion attached to the socket anteriorly, then passed down in front of the knee unit, and then passed under or attached to the roller at the end of radial arm, where radial arm extends from knee bolt at one end and shank to the other end. Mode of action. As the knee bends, tension is created in the kick strap. This stretching force controls heel rise or to accelerate forward swing of the shank. Advantage of this strap is simplicity, low cost, low maintenance, and easy adjustability. While disadvantage include tendency to extend knee during sitting, less cosmetic as it can be seen from the clothing. Another type of extension aid which is used is extension lever. Construction. As shown in finger 11, the upper end is attached to knee block at the pivot posterior to the knee center. The lower end is attached to extension bias spring, which is fastened to its other end to the upper part of the shank. Mode of action. As the knee bends, the spring is stretched, providing necessary straining force to control heel rise and to accelerate shank during early swing. Sometimes compression spring is used instead of tension spring, but function is same. Advantage of this lever is cost misses, as it cannot be shown from the clothing, and second is does not extend knee during sitting. Disadvantage include it is noisier because of more mechanical parts and difficult to adjust. Thank you for listening.